ሰላም ጤና ይስጥልኝ። ግሪቲንግስ ኦፍ ፒስ ኦን ቢሃፍ ኦፍ ዘ ገቨርንመንት ዘ ፒፕል ኤንድ ዘ ሚኒስትሪ ኦፍ ፒስ ኦፍ ዘ ፌደራል ዴሞክራቲክ ሪፐብሊክ ኦፍ ኢትዮጵያ አም ፕሊዝድ ቱ ዋርምሊ ግሪት ዩ አት ዘ ኦፕኒንግ ኦፍ ዘ ቨርቹዋል ግሎባል ፒስ ሊደርሺፕ ኮንፈረንስ 2020. I would also like to use this opportunity to thank and congratulate the International Host Committee of the Global Peace Leadership Conference 2020 for organizing this virtual conference with the theme Transforming Societies for Sustainable Peace and Development through Moral and Innovative Leadership in Education and Peacebuilding. It's unfortunate that I'm not able to meet with you all in person due to the COVID-19 pandemic challenge. As a young adult, I never pictured myself being involved in national matters that required me to take leadership roles. Even now, I'm often humbled to be leading the first of its kind Ministry of Peace in my country at a time where we are transitioning into a new era. This position comes with the great responsibility of achieving and nurturing a nation with sustainable peace. In the world today, we are realizing that taking peace for granted leaves us to deal with devastating impacts socially, economically, and politically. That's why at the Ministry of Peace, we strive to promote mainstreaming of peace in the daily lives of each and every individual. For peace begins within oneself. We believe that peace is holistic as it thrives through our relationship with those around us, as well as blossoms through our relationship with environment and even with Mother Nature. Sustainable peace in a nation means that there is a feasible chance for development in all spheres, including education. I would like to express the heartfelt solidarity of the Ministry of Peace with the Global Peace Leadership's mission of transforming education and promoting sustainable peace throughout sub-Saharan Africa. There is a famous saying in my country, "Dir biyabr, ambassa yasir," that translates to, "When the spider webs unite, they can tie up a line." I believe that standing together and joining our hands as Africans is the key to a better future for our continent. Also, the world is faced with both man-made and natural disasters that shake the foundation for peace. We particularly Africans need to strengthen our unity because African unity is not simply a dream, but a goal that can be achieved so as to transform and lead the continent towards a better tomorrow. I would like to end my remark today by reiterating that peace is not a mere absence of war. It begins within oneself. Let's all mainstream peace in our daily lives, in our development planning and implementation. Wishing you a very successful conference, I look forward to receive the proceedings. May peace prevail in Africa. May peace prevail in the world. I thank you very much. Stay healthy and safe.